Although sign languages were developed by deaf people and are used primarily in their purest form by people who are deaf, it is also used by hearing individuals, such as those that have difficulty with spoken language, to augment or use as an alternative way of communicating. And you may have noticed sometimes when referring to deaf people that they might use a capital D, and that's used for a specific purpose. So deaf with a big D are people that are not only deaf by way of auditory definition, but also culturally as well. So they identify with the deaf community, which has its own culture, its own history, customs, and beliefs. So if you see the capital D, that's why. And I mentioned that it could be used as, you know, to augment or as an alternative form of communication. And this is what we call AAC. So sign language can be a form of AAC, which is a huge umbrella term just to mean any device, method, or system used to supplement or use for communication when speech or language has not yet developed or is lost. So sign language can be a form of AAC when hearing people use it who cannot rely on their speech to communicate. The reasons why might be they have low intelligibility. And what I mean by that is intelligibility just means they're difficult to understand. So how well someone can understand them. And then it could be another reason they have difficulty maybe formulating or understanding messages. So they might use AAC. And then the how of AAC, this could be anything from, yeah, sign language, picture symbols, communication books, AAC apps, or speech generating devices like, you know, we see people communicating with iPads and other sorts of electronic devices. All right, here's our next one. So sign language early on will develop or delay speech development. When we think lots of wrong fit. Awesome. This is also wrong, yeah. I wouldn't be an SLP if I started teaching about sign language if I thought that, yeah, it would delay speech development. But with that said, this is actually a huge question we get all the time. You know, if I teach my son or daughter sign language, is this gonna, you know, remove them from wanting to talk and wanting to communicate? So it is a very common belief that a lot of people have.
Doesn't it actually make it easier for communication, maybe with the babies, like they're able to get through to you, like as parents? I think that's what I did with my daughter.
100%, yeah. What was your experience with your daughter?
So around 7 to 8 months, like she would say more with her hands and she would sign please, and she would just, I mean, I was able to communicate that through that, like at that, like 7 to 8 months mark. So just a few things, nothing major, like it's not like 2 or 3 syllables, just like plain simple, like water, just simple stuff.
Totally. And you totally summarize that really well, is that it won't, there's no real drawbacks, but if anything, it could help support an advanced communication. So yeah, to date, you know, a lot of research has been done on this subject. There's no evidence to suggest that sign interferes with that typical language development, which is awesome news that we care about. And some case studies have actually suggested the opposite, like you said, that these things can actually, there's a correlation to increased verbal skills if it's introduced early on.
Judy just in the chat said that she agrees she's heard a lot of people saying that they think that sign language will actually delay language development. So it does seem to be a very pervasive thought.
Super common thought, yeah. And a lot of the parents that we talk to, it's something that we hear a lot. You know, if I use this with them, is that going to be their preferred way? And I always tell parents, like, children will talk when they're ready. You know, and if a child, you know, can talk, they will talk. So this can be a really good way of bridging that gap or encouraging language development and speech in the meantime. So that's, yeah, a really, really common thought. Perfect. Awesome, which, yeah, brings us to our next why sign with the child? So we're all here, so why do we care about learning? So there are some known benefits to learning sign language. The first point, children acquire language sooner to communicate their needs or desires prior to the natural emergence of motor and linguistic development required to produce verbal speech. So someone mentioned, yeah, like I'm signing with my daughter who is really young and not yet using words. It can be a really good way if we think about, you know, children starting to talk around 1 year. They start to gesture before that around 9 months to 10 months. So this can cause them to acquire words and communicate a lot sooner, especially for, and this is particularly important for children with developmental delays, because their speech, if it is going to be delayed, it's a good way for them to be able to communicate as they're learning. And this provides them with a total communication approach. So providing a total communication approach, it aids in higher expressive and receptive skills in developmentally delayed children. And I'll go into a little bit of detail like what I mean by a total communication approach in a little bit. Being a visual gestural language, it aids in understanding for children who have visual strengths as opposed to auditory processing. Visuals meaning anything, you know, like signs or objects, anything meaningful that supports understanding. It can be really good for these kiddos who might have difficulty with auditory processing, and hence why we use it a lot with our kiddos at the Down Syndrome Resource Foundation or kids with autism who have this strength in terms of their visual skills. It's an unaided form of AAC. And all I mean by that is you always have your hands with you. So a lot of people who have communication delays, sometimes they'll use communication books, pictures, symbols, iPads to communicate, which is fabulous and fantastic. But see if, you know, their device isn't on them or it's not charged up. A lot of our students will use sign language as a backup. Or, you know, when they're out and about and don't have visuals, those kind of things. So it can be a good way to just always have something on you that you can use to communicate. It's also been shown to decrease in problem behaviors, which is huge. There is a correlation between problem behaviors and communication difficulties, because if we think about it, if you can't communicate your needs, sometimes this will come out in different behaviors. So rather than, you know, hitting or throwing, I can learn the signs for help or break, which can be really powerful for children to learn. There's also been some studies to suggest cognitive advancement in typically developing children, just particularly in attention and visual spatial skills.